In English first, page 39. When a patron comes to the monastery and offers money for food, the temple administrators should discuss it together, as is the custom of Buddhist monasteries. When donated materials are to be dispersed, also, they discuss it together. Do not violate their authority and create a disturbance in the job. After the lunch or breakfast has been properly prepared and placed on the table, the tenzo puts on the okesa, unfolds the zagu, and facing the sōdo, offers incense and does 9 prostrations. Then the food is sent out. Throughout the day and night, prepare lunch and breakfast without wasting time. If you sincerely arrange the implements and prepare food, all of your conduct and performance becomes the activity for the sustained development of a womb of sages. Taking the backward step of transforming the self is the way to bring ease to the community. Now, we in Japan already have heard the name Buddha Dharma for a long time. However, the venerable ones have not taught and previous people have not recorded the description of how to prepare monks' food respectfully. How much more have they not seen, even in a dream, the observance of doing 9 prostrations towards the monks' food? People in our country think that the way monks eat and the way food is prepared in the community is the same as the way birds and hairy beasts eat. Truly, we must pity this. Truly, we must grieve. What a shame. When this mountain monk, Dong, was in Tiantong Temple, a person named Yong from Qinghan Prefecture had the job of Tenzo. I happened to be passing through the eastern corridor on my way to the Chaoran hut after lunch when the Tenzo was drying mushrooms in front of the Buddha hall. He carried a bamboo cane but had no hat on his head. The sun beat down on the hot pavement and the sweat flowed down and drenched him as he resolutely dried the mushrooms. I saw he was trembling a bit, with his spine bent like a bow and his shaggy eyebrow, he looked like a crane. I approached and politely asked the Tenzo his age. He said he was 68. I asked, "Why do not have an attendant or lay worker do this?" The Tenzo said, "Others are not me." I said, "Esteemed sir, you are truly dedicated. The sun is so hot. Why are you doing this now?" The Tenzo said, "What time should I wait for?" I immediately withdrew, thinking to myself as I walked away, I deeply appreciated that this job expresses the essential function.
しばらく参りいたします。
First, I would like to speak about this short encounter between Dogen when he was in China and this Tenzo. Really short but interesting. The answers of the Tenzo are maybe a little bit strange. When Dogen asked him, "Why do you not have an attendant or lay worker? Why do you not have an attendant or lay worker?" Do this, because the Tenzo was walking, it was, it seems a bit difficult work. And the Tenzo said, "Others are not me." What does it mean, this answer, "Others are not me"? Usually when we use this me, we can think about material me, my body, maybe. We have this wall or this limit body inside. It's me outside. It's not me. So all this thing inside my body is like me, there's a limit. This is a material me, my body, me. And we can think also about an immaterial me, something more intellectual, abstract, more connected to society. Maybe we build something like me in our head. And so this me, intellectual me, built by me and other people and the society, can also be really strong. It's like maybe a second body, a second material body, because it could be really, really strong. So when we think about a general me, a conventional me, we can add this to me, material me, my body, and me, something more material. When we add this, we can have kind of mi. So when the tenzo, he said, horses are not mi, maybe we can understand this like something a bit arrogant, a bit pride. He knows what is his me, and so he thinks maybe that to do this job, only him is able to do this job in a good way. So he said to Dogen, others are not me, only me can do this. So if you think like that, the Tenzo is trying to compare him to other people. And in conclusion said that only him could do his job. But we can try to understand it in another way. I like to think about my material body and my intellectual body, immaterial me, like a real tool of experience. Try to draw something. We can maybe represent our me like something like a reception post, maybe something like around this me, material, immaterial in the same place, another element, we are inside this environment, and we can receive and also make some message. I think in this environment we receive a lot of things. You can also answer to this message. But the most interesting thing in this environment is that all this information, all this maybe experience that we have, we can only leave them through this reception post, through this point. Of course, I can think that, I can imagine to build theory about other people around me. Someone here, or here. But basically, when I leave experience, when I receive a message, I cannot forget the fact that all gonna pass through this body and mind. So, but basically, there is only me. Maybe if I lost this body and mind, all this theory about my environment, about society, gonna die with me. If I think like that, if I understand that, if I want to have a kind of knowledge, I have to receive all in my mind and body. So maybe, finally, there is only me, maybe. It's like, seems to be a little bit egocentric theory. This kind of big I, big me. But if we reach this layer, if we think about this big I, the notion of me and non-me won't exist. Why? Usually, we think about me and other people in terms of duality. The better I know what another people is, better I know me. So the direction of the kind of energy is like that. The more I know other people, the more I know me. But if I accept this theory, the fact that my body is like an experienced body, if I want to know who is another people, I have to live his life, but really live his life. I take all his experience, that maybe his people receive a lot of things, a lot of experience, a lot of message. I have to take all this stuff to put them in my body experience to be able maybe to really know his life. But I cannot do that. If I want to live the life of Sebastian, I have to take all his moments with his family, with his girlfriend in the beach, with his beer, and all I can take from that. Lives his life and also know what is his life, but it's impossible. So at the end, as I'm not able to know who is Sebastian, I won't be able to really know me, because better I know who is Sebastian, better I know who I am. So I don't know who is Sebastian, so I don't know who I am. So at the end, it's not really an egocentric theory, because I'm not in opposition with other people. I'm not comparing myself with other people. So it's a big me, but not really a me, because there is no another people. So when the Tenzo, when he speaks about others are not me, I don't really think that at this moment you want it to be arrogant. But for me it was just the constatation, that maybe there's no other people. I can imagine them. Imagine that you are real here in front of me, but not real proof. Maybe. Just imagine that. So for me, the Tenzo, when he says, what time should I wait for? Others are not me. For me, he just wants to put his body and mind, his reception post, in this job of Tenzo. And he knows that if he doesn't do that, no one will do it. Of course, he's the only one here. So, for me, I understand this. I can understand this like that. Tenzo knows that he's maybe a little bit finally alone, and he wants to try this Tenzo job, so he does it. But why? Why this Tenzo job? What is so interesting in this job? Before Dogen speak about that, for him, the Tenzo job becomes the activity for the sustained development of a womb of sages. So if it's a bomb, maybe this job will make you rise again, gives you a relevant, interesting, essential experience of life. But when I think about Tenzo, cooking, washing dishes, make fire, set the table, be on time, I don't really feel born again. So why? Why this Tenzo job should be a womb of sages? To tell the truth, I don't know. I don't really know why. And I don't want to know why. Because if I try to, I think if I try to like find a purpose, but then when I will be a Tenzo, I will understand that and become someone like that and receive kind of power. I'm sure that I won't receive anything, but like because it's an experience, I will receive something. I want that I don't expect, maybe, but of course I will receive something. What? I don't know. So I like to see life like a big matter of experience. Dogen sees a Tenzo job like a womb of sages, why not? But life and all experiences or moment in life, if I want them to be a womb of sages, all moments could be womb of sages. To go to pachinko, karaoke, to be here, limoninko, spill my soup in the tatami. All could be, for me, if I want to see it like a womb of sages, something interesting. For me, life is a big experience. I don't know if non-experience exists. Is there a place that is not an experience in my life, a moment that is not an experience? I don't think. Satori is samsara. Samsara is Satori. So, in this life, what else? What other things could I possess? I just have my moments here. So, in this moment, good, bad, painful, happy, in this moment, because I just have that. I will try to see through these moments, something like a pure expression of life. In this job of Tenzo, why not? But also in all these moments that constitute my. If I want, I can discriminate moments. Of course, I'm here. I wanted to be here. I didn't want to be in another place. So I can choose what experience I want to live. But I'm not really sure that this experience is gonna be the good experience for me. Because I don't see really an accurate hierarchy between experiences. But I can try to this experience or another experience. Of course, experience transform us. I can accept it if I want, and if I accept it, can see impermanence in all, in each moment, in each emotion, in nature. So my reception post kept a lot of informations and try to maybe adapt itself to the environment. I learn from it, from this environment, and I am transformed each second. Impermanence in each moment. But I can also refuse this message, this experience of life. And then my reception post works in a specific way. Don't want really to receive message from outside. But these two attitudes, accepting messages or refusing messages, are also two pure experience of life. I don't want to say that we should learn a lot from our environment. I can choose to learn a lot from my environment, but I won't criticize the one who doesn't want. So yeah, two pure experience in accepting and refusing. You can choose the one you want to live. For Rogan, he used really strong word, womb of sages, to speak about this tender work. So now we can really understand the respect he has for this tender work. When he speak about the tenzo that had to put the okesa to unfold the dagu facing the sodo. But maybe we should do that for each moment, for the tenzo moment, but why not for all this little moment that is given to us. So for me, I understand this little conversation between Dogen and Tenzo. For me, the Tenzo thinks like Dogen that this Tenzo job is really important, so he decides to put his body and mind, all that he has, maybe, in this situation of Tenzo, in this job. I want to read a quotation to finish, maybe in short. A quotation from Merleau-Ponty, his French philosopher, if you want to categorize him. We can categorize him in the like a phenomenologist. He wrote really interesting book named Phénoménologie de la Perception, so English Perceptions, Phenomenology. And he wrote something interesting like that. We don't have to wonder if we really perceive a world, but the contrary. The world is what we perceive. So what could I say about that? Maybe we don't have to search something true around us. All our perceptions are our world. True or not is not maybe a relevant question. So, if you have some question about what is it? Welcome.
I would like to know what you think of a sentence here.
Yes.
Taking the backward step of transforming the self is the way to bring ease to the community.
I'm not really sure to understand this sentence. Taking the backward step of transforming the self, I don't really understand it. Maybe it means something like forget the self. I don't really know. If we think about the community, if we want to bring ease to this community, maybe we have to really serve it. Something like a me that could be this kind of me. Usually in a position with other, won't give me the opportunity to really serve the community, because it's really complicated to always be in this who I am and try to always compare me that I don't know with another people that also I don't know. And I can know. So maybe taking the backward step could be to go in the direction of the big me. It's possible or not, I don't really know. To leave it, to really leave it. A big me that is not really a me, because another people won't exist in this theory. So I kind of just doing my job of Tenzo without me and without another people. I don't know if it's realistic, possible, or just in theory. But yeah, something like losing myself. But in this point, there is no self or no not self. So maybe this configuration, this kind of big I could bring ease to the community. But to really live it and experience it may be complicated. Thanks.
Well, from the viewpoint of the big I, there's no me and no others, right? So in that case, it doesn't matter who's drying the mushrooms. If it's me or if you are doing it, it's all part of the big I.
Yeah, maybe.
So why does the Tenzo say another is not me? He could say, oh, that's a good idea. Please, Dogen, you do it, and it's still part of the big self.
Yeah, but the only thing that I can feel is going to be this big me. this, yeah, maybe I have to say before that I have to be able to perceive something, to feel something, maybe. If another, that even if the other one doesn't really exist, only me can live this experience. Only me. Only this moving life. Because when I do it, it's like maybe everyone is doing it. But when another do it, it's not really me, maybe.
So why does he answer Dogen's question?
Sorry?
Dogen asks a question and the cook answers the question.
Is the second question?
The first or the second, both. I mean, Dogen wants to know, why don't you use an assistant for this work? And Tenzo says, another person is not me. And then Dogen says, why don't you do it some other time when it's not so hot? And Tenzo says, for what time should I wait if I don't do it now? If the Tenzo can't even be sure that Dogen exists, why would he bother to answer his questions? Why would he want to communicate with him? Everything he know, he experiences him. There's only the big self, big me. So Dogen isn't really existing, right? For the Tenzo. So why would he bother to answer him a question if he can't even be sure that...
Even if it's me, maybe I'm not sure to know, to be conscient of me. So maybe all the world is me.
Yes.
But not maybe a me that I can know. It's me, for me, doesn't mean that I know it. For example, I don't know if I maybe in theory I forget myself. I have never been in South America. Even South America is a part of me because I forget myself. I would like to visit South America maybe. And maybe Dogen here, even if he speaks with himself, with the Tenzo, he doesn't really know who is the Tenzo. Even if the Tenzo is him. That is complicated, man. Too much. Yeah. I try to speak a lot about these nebulous things, and yeah, the more I speak, the more I'm lost, because I won't find any answers at the end. So
you think you can learn as much from being in the pachinko or being Tenzo? So why do you think is the purpose of going to a place of practice?
It depends on in which world I want to be, in which kind of system I want to use. If I want to use my maybe ego system, I can create a hierarchy and say, oh, maybe I prefer to do this job of Tenzo instead of going to pachinko, because Tenzo, I work for a community, I can concentrate myself in a way I would like. So maybe I'm doing a choice and say, oh, this is a good path for me. But if I use another system, more large maybe, what is going to prove me that the Tenzo is more efficient than a pachinko? I have no proof about that. I have to say, I don't know, I can have big concentration in my work of Tenzo. I can also have a big concentration in my pachinko. I can have pleasure doing to be a cooker. I have a lot of pleasure, but so I won't find a relevant answer. It depends on my point of view. Relative, maybe, point of view and personal egocentric point of view. So maybe no difference, but if I want to get the difference again. Any other questions? Maybe.
Good. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.